Hello, welcome to the video How to Scrapbook. So first, we start out with a scrapbook. There are a variety of colors and sizes that you can purchase. It's really up to you. Some people even choose to create their own. However, I find that very difficult and would rather just purchase a professional one. Next up, you have to choose the supplies you would like to scrapbook. The primary supplies you will need are photographs, of course. Beware though, photo printing can be quite costly depending on how many you buy, if you want them shipped, or where you buy them from. Once you order your pictures, allot some time, roughly a week, for the photos to arrive. In the meantime, you can gather other supplies necessary. For the basic tools I recommend are, as mentioned, photographs, a scrapbook, some scissors or a paper cutter of some sort, glue sticks, a writing utensil, this can be like a pen or a Sharpie, and then any extra decorations you would like. With all the supplies ready and available, you can start your process of scrapbooking. Scrapbooking is basically using pictures and words to tell your story and relive your experiences. Contrary to popular opinion, scrapbooking does not have to be hard. I like to think of it as organized chaos. For those who don't know where to start, I'll go over some tips just to keep in mind as you scrapbook, but of course it's all up to you and what you want and what you want your scrapbook to look like. So my first tip is on my design philosophy. Basically, photos are the key to your book. They tend to be the first thing your eye is drawn to, so definitely try to work around your photos as you're laying out your decorations and your spread. Secondly, choose a theme. Your theme could simply be your life or memories that you have. I like to categorize my scrapbooks based on different aspects of my life, so either travel, friends, different stages of my school experiences, or family. My third tip is color coordination. This is your time to shine and express your creativity. Personally, I like to color coordinate my photos with the accessories that I add. So if there's lots of blue in a photo, I might want to add a variety of like blue backgrounds and borders to my photo spread. Tip of decorate with a purpose. While additions like stamps and stickers can really bring your spread to life, it can also clutter your space and then draw attention away from your photos, which may not be what you want. My last tip is if you want to add memories or elaborate on photographs, if the photos don't capture everything that you want to say, you can add captions. So pre-think what you want to write, and you can test it on another sheet of paper so that you don't mess up in the actual scrapbook. But don't fret if you do though, because you can always put a shape or some type of sticker over the mess up, or even just add another piece of paper with your text on it. Overall, these were a few tips I've gained from my years of scrapbooking. I hope you all enjoyed it.